Hello everyone, welcome back. Today I am going to explain to you on list loop, list mutability, aliasing and cloning list in Python. Let's get started. First thing I am going to explain to you is list looping. So what is a list? List is a set of values enclosed in a square bracket and all the elements are separated by comma. So it is similar to an array in C language. So list, it is easier to use in Python. So usually you can able to store multiple data types in list, whereas in array you can store only similar data types, but in list you can store different data types. Okay, so now I am going to explain to you how to work looping in list. The first is for loop. So how to use for loop in list? So for this, I have opened a spider software here. I have worked out a program already. So you can see the program here on the left hand side. My list will be equal to, within the square bracket, I have enclosed a set of elements, CSE, ECE, EEE, mechanical and IT. You can see this, since the elements are string values, I have given single quote. You can use single quote or otherwise you can use double quote for this. So next I am using a for loop. For items, it is a variable name in my list colon and I have to give one indentation. Next, I am printing this items. So what this items will do is, it will be pointing to each element in a list. First, it will be pointing to CSE. For the first time when it is traversing, it will be pointing to CSE and it will print of items, will print the CSE on screen. Next time when it is traversing, it will be automatically incremented and it is pointing to ECE. Now ECE will be printed on screen. Next, EEE will be printed and next is mechanical and IT. All these elements in the list will be traversed and it will be printed on screen. Now I'll tell you how to run this program. So when I run this green color button, you'll get the output on screen, CSE, ECE, EEE, mechanical and IT. Okay, so I'll run one more program in list. So here in this list, if you see this program, I have stored all the integer values, 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. I've stored inside a variable called num. I am using the same concept. Instead of here, I have used a variable called items. Now here, I have used a variable called I. For I in num, print of I. So I will be pointing to 10. Next, it will be pointing to 20, 30, 40 and 50. So when I run this program, I'll get all the values on screen. So this is how you have to use your for loop. Okay. Next is how to use range and length function in list looping. So I have opened one more program, third program. So you can see this num will be equal to 10, 20, 30, 40 and 50. I have stored some set of elements inside num. So here, instead of giving directly this list name, that is num here, I am using two more keywords like range and length. What is this length function will do is, len of num will tell you the length of the list. So what is the length of this list? It is 5. So length of num will give you 5. What is range of 5? Range of 5 will give you the values from the starting value. Suppose if you are giving a starting value, it will take the starting value. Suppose if you are not giving the starting value, it will start the value from 0 onwards. So 0 till 5, that means 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, suppose range of 5, it will take the value 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So for I in range of length of num, that means this num, it will be pointing to the 0th value of the 0th location. Then I will be pointing to the second location and third location, likewise it will be pointing. So now I am going to use print of num of I. What is num of I? Num of 0. Okay, next time it will be num of 1, num of 2, num of 3 and num of 4. What is num of 0? Num of 0 is 10. Next time 1 is 20, num of 2 is 30, and num of 3 is 40, and num of 4 is 50. So what is this range and length of num is going to do is that it is going to give you the values. Range of length of num will give you the values 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So I will be having a value 0. Next time I will be having the value 1. I will be having the value 2. Like this it goes on. So when I is 0, num of 0 will be 10. When I is 1, num of 1 is 20. Likewise, it will print all the values. So, you can use directly this num list in your for loop, or otherwise, you can use range of length of function in your for loop. So, this statement will also print the same values on your output. Is it okay? Okay. Next, we move on to the next topic called list mutability. List or mutable, that means we can able to add, delete or replace any value in the list at any time. That is a speciality of the list. So if you want to add or delete or any other element or update any element, you can use this mutable concept. How you can able to add a new element is my list of index will be equal to value. So using this syntax, you can able to add or delete or update the values. Let's see how you are working this program in Python language. Okay. So I have opened a fourth program here. So you can see this. First I'll clear the screen here. Clear. So you can see this, I have stored the values like 55, 48, 56, 75, 87 and 37 I have stored in my list. I am using a print statement, print old list values or my list. So this statement will print all the elements in my screen. And third statement, I am going to update the fourth value. What is this fourth value? 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. That means 87. I am going to change this 87 with 170. So if I give this statement, this 87 will be updated. So when I print this new set of values, my list, I'll get the value as 55, 48, 56, 75, 170 and 37. Okay, we'll run this program. You can see this old list values are 55, 48, 56, 75 and 87. New list values, it will be updated. Instead of 87, it is updated as 170. So, if you want to change any value, you can directly give the location and you can change the value. The new value can be given it like this. So, this is a syntax for updating a new value. So, this property is called as list mutability property. Okay, next concept I'm going to explain to you is aliasing. So what is aliasing? An object with more than one reference and one name is called aliasing. Okay, so we all know we use our names Bharat alias Ram. That means he is having different names, two different names. A same person will be referred by two different names. That is called aliasing. The same concept, we are going to use it in list. So you can see here, the list I'm having a list with set of elements like 1, 2 and 3. Already it is named as my list. Now I'm going to give one more name to this new list. So both new list and my list will be referring to the same set of elements. This is called aliasing. So I'll tell you how to work with aliasing now. So you can see this, I have stored 100, 200 and 300 in old list. Now I am going to give the aliasing concept. That means old list, new list will be equal to old list. This is a statement for your aliasing. What it means is that I am going to store old list elements inside your new list elements. That means both new list and old list are pointing to the same set of elements. Now I am going to print this old list. And I'm printing the new list also. Next line, what I have done is, I have updated old list of 0 will be equal to 1. Instead of 100, I have updated with a value called 1. Now I want to check whether I will get this updation will also be reflected in your new list or not. So now I'm going to print this old list and I'm printing new list. Whether this updation will be reflected in your new list or not, that is what we are going to see it. So when I run this program, you can see that it is reflected. That means since if any changes you made in the old list, that will also be reflected in the new list, because both old list and new list are referring to the same set of elements. So this is your aliasing. You can see here. So new list will be old list, and I'm updating the old list. So whatever the change you have made in old list, that will also be updated in your new list also. This is aliasing concept. I think you understood this program. I'll move on to the next program called, next concept called cloning. So what is cloning? Cloning is different from aliasing. Okay, so in aliasing, we are not going to create a copy to the new list. But coming to the cloning, we are going to create a copy of the existing list. So any change you are going to made in the old copy will not be reflected in your new copy. That is called cloning. So we have heard this cloning in many movies, right? So what is cloning here? In Endran film, we have heard this cloning concept, right? So what is this cloning will do? You are going to create a carbon copy of one person. So when you create a carbon copy, so whatever changes you made in old one will not be reflected here. It is a new carbon copy. So it is a new person. So it will not be reflected in the new person. This is called cloning list. Okay, so here you can see this old list and new list are pointing to same set of elements. After cloning, I'll have separate copy. Old list will be separate and new list will be separated. Okay, I'll help you how to work out this cloning. So there are various methods of creating this cloning. So there are three methods you can create the cloning concept in list. The first one is making use of function called list of. List of function will help you to create a cloned copy. So you have to use the syntax like this. New list will be equal to list of old list. So when you do it like this, old list a copy will be created and it will be stored separately in the new list. So now new list will be pointing to separate set of elements and old list will be pointing to separate set of elements. Okay, so this is the list cloning. So here I have stored apple, orange and jackfruit. First I'll clear the screen here. Apple, orange and jackfruit I have stored in old. Now I'm going to create a cloning. I'm going to do a cloning. New will be equal to list of old. That means you are going to create a carbon copy and it is stored in new. So now I'm going to print old and new value. And after which I try to change old of 0. Instead of apple, I am going to change it as pomegranate. Now I am going to print old and new value. Whether the changes will be reflected or not, let's see. You can see this, old list value is pomegranate, but new list value remains the same, apple. Because this shows that this is a cloning concept, where whatever the change you made in the old list will not be reflected in your new list, because you have created a copy of it. Is it okay, students? So old will be equal to apple, orange and jackfruit. New equal to list of old will create a clone copy and it is stored in new. When you display this old and new, you will get this apple, orange and jackfruit. New list also you will get it. And now I am going to change the old of 0 app instead of apple to pomegranate. So when I print old and new, I will get old list as pomegranate, orange and jackfruit and new list as apple, orange and jackfruit. I think you are clear with this program. We move on to the next concept, that is called copy. So I have told you there are three methods you can do cloning. First method is list. Second method is copy. So you can use this syntax. New list will be equal to copy dot copy of old list. This will also create a carbon copy of your old list. But this process is little bit slower than list. Since it has to determine the data type of the old list first, it will take some time to create a carbon copy. So you can also create a carbon copy by using a method called copy dot copy of old list. Okay, let's see in the program now. Okay, so for this copy is a method or module which you need to import it from import. So I am going to use import copy and I am storing this 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 in old list. Now I am going to use this method copy.copy of old list. This will create a carbon copy and it will get stored in new list. Now I am going to print old list and new list over here, and then I'm trying to update old list of 0 instead of 10. I'm going to store it as 5, and I'm printing old list and new list now. So I'll run this program. See here, first old list is printed, new list is also printed. Next, I'm trying to update the value. Instead of 10, it has updated to 5. So I'm getting 5, 20, 30, 40 and 50. Next, I'm going to print this new list. It is not updated, so I'll get the same old values. Okay, so you can do carbon copy. You can do this cloning by three ways. One is by using list method. The second is by using copy method. And third method is deep copy. In deep copy, similar to copy method, this is also very slowest and it is memory consuming method, since you are going to copy deeply from old set to the new set. So what is the change you have to do is, instead of copy, you have to give deep copy over here. Okay, we will see the program now. So you see this import copy old list, I'm storing 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. So here I'm going to give the statement as copy dot deep copy of old list that gets stored in new list. Now I'm going to print old list, new list, and then old list and new list. Okay. First I'll clear the screen here. So when I run this program, I'll get 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. New list also the same, but when I made the change in old list, I'll get the change over here, 5, 20, 30, 40, 50, but this is not reflected in your new list. Okay, so the cloning is over. Next, we move on to the next topic, that is called function return method. List parameters. So how you can able to pass the parameters inside the list? That is what the next concept. I'm going to tell you how to insert elements in the list. So for this, function parameters. So here, this is a function, def insert is a function which is having one parameter called t, colon t dot insert of 1, 15. This is a function, we will come later. So this is a main program. My list is equal to 10, 20 and 30. I'm storing 10, 20, 30 inside your my list, and I'm printing this my list. Next, I'm going to use a statement called insert of my list. So this statement will call this insert function here. My list is the elements 10, 20, 30. It gets copied into t value 10, 20, 30. So we know there is a method called insert method that is available in your Python. T dot insert of 1, 15 will insert this element inside this location 1. It will insert a value called 15. So what is the first location? 0, 1. So here you are going to insert 15. So you will get the answer as 10, 15, 20 and 30. So when I print the values afterwards, after finishing this function, it will return back to the main program. Then if you print this my list, I will get the value as 10, 20 and 30. So you can pass the entire list as a parameter to a function. You can see it over here. So insert of my list, here I am passing the entire list as a parameter to a function. So this function will receive this element, and inside that I am doing this operation. So I'll run this program. You can see this, before inserting I was having 10, 20 and 30, and after inserting the value I was having the value 10, 15, 20 and 30. This is how you can pass the parameter to a function. Okay. And last is how to create and return a new list. So for this, I have done one more program. So we'll see how you're going to return the entire list. So likewise, this is a function, we will come later. So I'm storing 10, 20, 30, 40, 50 in my list, and I'm printing this my list, display of my list. So that means this function, we'll call this function. My list is sent as a parameter, so the entire elements is passed as a parameter over here. So here I have not done anything, just I'm going to return the entire list back to the main program. See it here, return of t of colon, that means I'm returning the entire list 10, 20, 30, 40, I'm returning it to the new program, to the main program. So now the new list will contain 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Now I print the new list, I'll get the entire set of elements. So you can use this concept to pass the parameters to a function and to return values. Okay, I think you all understood the concepts what you have explained today. So I have explained to you about on list looping and then list aliasing and what is list cloning. List cloning, we have discussed three methods. One is list method, other one is copy method, and third one is deep copy method. At last, I've explained to you on function passing the list as a parameter and also returning the list to the returning function, that is like how to return list values to a function. That is what I have explained to you. Thank you all for watching.